Welcome, everyone, to the NBA on 2K Sports. With Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. Doris Burke will be along, too, from the sideline. We've got a chance now for our starting lineups from point guard to center. This game should be a good one. First for Toronto, Lowry and Ross pairing up in the backcourt. And at the five, the fifth overall pick in the 2011 draft, a fleet-footed 6'11 big man out of Lithuania, Jonas Valanciunas. Then it's DeRozan, and it's Johnson in at the four. And for the Nets, Deron Williams out there with Livingston. And patrolling the paint, one of the fiercest defenders in NBA history and former MVP and Defensive Player of the Year, the big ticket, Kevin Garnett. Then there's Johnson, and it's Pierce in at the four slot. Now here's Valanciunas. Shoots, arm's length from the hoop, he knocks it down. Valanciunas has got the opening basket of the game for the Raptors. Toronto on defense. Now here's Williams. From 18 feet away, rebounded by Valanciunas.
You know, Deron Williams suffered a lot of injuries in the first half of last season and finally got healthy in the second half, and it showed. He was fantastic during the last 30 or 40 games or so. I think now with all this talent around him, the situation is perfect for Williams to reestablish himself as one of the elite players in this league.
Now recovering, the jump hook, and Williams with the nice bucket inside. We play just over a minute here in the first. And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
I had a chance to talk with the head coach for Brooklyn. He told me there aren't many big men with the mobility and length of Jonas Valanciunas, and that he's a player they'll really have to account for, saying, quote, JV's still developing his skill set, but there just aren't that many people in the world of his size. And you factor in his motor, he can really impact a game. Guys, we'll see how they try to deal with him.
All right, Doris, thank you very much. And for Williams last season, he seemed to get better, Clark, as the season wore on, not usually the case with injuries.
But I think he, like a lot of players, Kevin, may have still been recovering from the grind of the condensed schedule two seasons ago. You know, he started playing in Turkey before starting that tough, shortened season. So you factor in Team USA play in the summer, he put a lot of wear and tear on his body, and I think it just took a while for it to rebound.
And it's Johnson penetrating. Kicks to Ross. Some nice ball movement here by the Raptors. Stolen by Pierce. Inside. Livingston, no luck.
Offensively, 1 of 4 to start. They're still trying to find their stroke.
Valanciunas, good.
Purely from a size standpoint, that is a mismatch that's going to be hard to overcome defensively. You know, it appeared to be another season where the Raptors would be near the bottom of the league, but while the terms rock bottom and embarrassing floated around, they made some moves and were able to go on a run to climb towards the middle of the pack.
Garnett battles through traffic and lays it in.
Boy, he crashed the boards with purpose right there. Well-deserved second-chance points for him.
Lowry up top. He's guarded by Williams. Here is Ross. He feeds it to DeRozan. Pass to Lowry from past the arc, and the shot is good. Lowry's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Well, we all know the trade for Rudy Gay, the major move coming last season for the Raptors. They were able to get a look at the playoff scenario at times. And you know, Steve, it looked like they were much more competitive down the stretch.
Yeah, this is a team that has struggled the last few years, but I think that spark near the end of the regular season gives them hope. And now it's time to start that climb, get back into the playoffs, and continue to build and become an excellent NBA franchise, because they have the potential to do so.
Now Lowry, after the missed three from Joe Johnson. Here's DeRozan. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry.
Their offense already flowing. Some stellar shooting while jumping out to this lead.
Well, high-quality shots, and they've been on target with them.
Now here's Johnson. He's had some playing time, but no scoring yet from him. And it's Johnson again missing. Raptors leading by 7. Rejected by Pierce. And here is Williams. Joe Johnson on the way. Pass to Livingston. Back to Johnson. Shoots the three. Another miss by Johnson. Toronto's gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. Here's Ross, buries the 7-footer.
And you'll see Dwayne Casey on the sidelines for Toronto. You know, he was the architect of the defense in Dallas when they won the championship back in 2011. So much deserved job for him here in Toronto. And I think he'll have plenty of success.
Now here's Pierce. And they get it. Johnson can't get it to go.
It has not been an easy quarter for him, at least offensively speaking.
Here's Ross. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up. And that defense in Dallas that Dwayne Casey developed as an assistant. Liberal use of zone defenses, Steve, and it was pretty impressive.
Yeah, and it was great for the personnel that the Mavs had, but it was a very innovative zone, kind of a hybrid zone, like a switching man-to-man type thing, like a almost like a college matchup zone that you see. And I think we're going to see more and more teams, Kevin, playing zones as the NBA continues to evolve. More and more teams playing smaller, running more, playing shooters all over the floor. So zones do make sense, and Coach Casey really is at the forefront of that trend.
Williams, the pass to Livingston, Johnson outside, he passes to Plumlee, that's good, and Johnson with the assist.
He was one step ahead of the defense when he fired that pass for the assist.
Raptors leading by 8. Now Lowry, he dishes it to Valanciunas, pass to DeRozan. Johnson left side, goes up and lays it nice and easy.
Defensively, this team is just giving up way too many open looks.
You're exactly right, and to battle back, they've got to shore that defense up, Steve.
Now here's Williams. Back to Pierce, 6 on the shot clock. Johnson with a screen on DeRozan. Pierce for 3. It's hauled in by the Raptors. DeRozan's got 3 rebounds now in this one. Johnson dishes to Ross. And DeRozan kicks to Lowry. The dive for the ball. But they recover it. Here's Valanciunas. No good. And Brooklyn will come the other way. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time getting the lid off the basket so far.
Well, it's been an interesting few years for Deron Williams and a lot of controversy involving his coaches. So Williams looking for stability and also I think looking for maybe an improved reputation as this season unfolds.
Free throw good, Williams. Going back to Williams-Clark and the coaching change, do you think he had a hand in that or not? It's so hard to speculate.
It really is, Kevin. I agree with you there. I think it's overblown, quite honestly. You have to remember, playing in the Big Apple, the storylines will abound. True or not, and they sometimes can take on a life of their own.
Well, the same thing happened to Utah now, too, under him.
Yeah, well, again, I think some of that, there may have been a little bit to it, but again, I think overblown is the best way to look at it. You know, as great as 2012 was for the Nets, in many ways, they really came up short on their last game of that calendar year. In 2012, the New Year's Eve matchup against the Spurs, the Nets only scored 5 points in the third quarter of that contest.
And, Clark, you were talking about the Nets. They went from looking like a team that could compete for a title to a team that, while still talented, Steve, and a lot for the playoffs, was a little closer to the middle of the pack than they thought.
Well, with the hot start they got off to, I think it was just a matter of time before they hit a cold stretch. And never fun to be held to just 5 points in a quarter. And that game had a lot of Nets fans wondering how the rest of the season would go. But, hey, they got it back together and still finished off pretty well.
Now here's Williams. That one wide left. Raptors leading by 10. And there's the feed to Ross. Back to DeRozan. Releases. Money from the wing. DeRozan's got his 2nd bucket.
They haven't been able to stifle him defensively here.
No, their offense continues to click.
Williams gets to Thornton. Back to Williams. Feeds to Plumlee. Nice D from Ross.
In terms of rebounding, it's been a sensational opening quarter.
I like sensational. That's a good word for it.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
Here's Johnson. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. That's on Patrick Patterson.
All right, you look at the Joe Johnson trade for the Nets. They picked up his max contract from the Hawks, committing $80 million over 4 years. But, you know, last season, his lowest point output in over a decade. A down season overall, but hey, there's a lot of talent on this team. He's not expected to score as much anymore.
And the Raptors making a change here. Salmons has checked in. And for the Nets, they started the season doing some of that isolation offensively for Joe Johnson that we saw in Atlanta, Clark.
And even with the most efficient individual scorers, that's not usually the way to go offensively over the long haul. With Joe going through a bit of a lull in terms of his shooting percentages, I thought they might have been better served to anchor the offense around Brook Lopez inside.
Boy, what a fantastic opening quarter for them.
Yeah, it sure has been. Look at the lead they've jumped out to already. Impressive.
Andre Blotch, he's checked in for Joe Johnson. Brooklyn with the ball. It's a 13-point game. Thornton with it. No scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Nets passing it around. A three from Anderson. Toronto's gone 2 of 4 from beyond the arc to start the game. Salmons kicks to Patterson. From outside, off the mark.
Kind of rare to see him come up empty on a wide open look.
Anderson passes to Kirilenko. Back to Anderson. He kicks it to Kirilenko. The dish to Blotch. Patterson on him. Five to shoot. Back to Blotch. Knocked loose. Shot from Trout. Whoops, there's the 24-second shot clock violation, so they'll turn it over. Here's a Zeletovic just checked in for the Nets. Toronto leading by 13. Lowry drives in. Dishes it to Nova. Back to Lowry. Kicks it to Salmons. Vasquez gets a screen from Patterson. Got a piece of it. Here's Blotch. And that one is hammered home.
Guys, that's simply superb. Ball pressure, a run out, and then a dunk in transition.
Exactly, Clark, what they wanted, the aggressive defense to lead to.
Yeah, points in transition.
Yeah, that's why you want to make the other team feel uncomfortable handling the ball, because you can get easy points out of it at the other end.
Here's Lowry. After the basket by Brooklyn. Salmons, no luck.
And already we've got a very lopsided edge on the board for them.
Yep, plus five in rebounds. That didn't take long.
Shoots from the block. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
You look at Marcus Thornton out of LSU, 6'4", a scoring guard. He can really light it up in a hurry off the bench.
Free throw dropped for Thornton. And for Thornton, a second rounder back in 2009. His size does hurt him defensively, but you'd have to say he's exceeded expectations, Clark.
I think so, Kevin. He surprised a lot of people with his ability to provide instant offense. He is pretty locked in with tunnel vision offensively. He's myopic now at that end of the floor. He's thinking about getting the ball and scoring the ball. But in his role, I think he's perfect for it.
Now here's Patterson. Salmons from outside. It's rebounded by Thornton. Kirilenko against Salmons. Kirilenko into the lane. Gets to the rim for two with the D all over him. Kirilenko's got his first points of the game. So timeout called here, the first for Toronto.
You know, it wasn't a surprise that the Raptors struggled on the road. Most young teams do. They were 13-28 as the visiting team. They did end the year looking a lot more dangerous on the road than they started, though.
Lowry kicks to Novak, puts the lead pass in front of him. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here. Well, Clark, you were talking about the Raptors' struggles on the road. They didn't have the best road record at the end of the season, as you said, but Steve, they did show some bite with their play.
You know, one of the interesting stats from the Raptors last year is they actually scored more points on the road than they did at home, and that rarely happens in the NBA. But I think the big thing with Toronto, their defense has to improve more than anything else.
Watch, Patterson defending, and Watch kicks to Teletovich. Now here's Anderson, looking for his first basket still in this one. Shot clock at 6. The shot by Butch, no good. Raptors leading by 8. Salmons with it. Now Kirilenko defending. Vasquez kicks to Patterson. Stolen by Anderson. In transition, here come the Nets. Horton's got the ball. Anderson outside. He feeds it to Teletovich. Anderson. Clock at 6. Pass to Teletovich. Hits the 3-point bomb. Teletovich has got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3. Raptors shooting well right out of the gates here at around 50%. Patterson, the screen. No good for Novak.
That's really too easy a chance to miss, guys. He needs to be more aggressive and focused on his finishes.
20 seconds left to play here in the first. And Thornton kicks to Anderson. Shoots it up. And he nails the jumper. Now it's just a 3-point Raptor lead. Here is Lowry. To the inside. This one for 3. So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Raptors lead by 3. 2K Sports back in a moment here in Brooklyn. And welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. More action in store as the players get ready to go, having a nice break to get hydrated with Gatorade. And Steve and Clark and I are refreshed and ready to go here as well. And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the Raptors.
And they're doing a fantastic job of finding the open man and getting easy looks.
You know, it also hasn't taken them long to make their mark in the paint. I mean, they're doing a lot of their scoring from in there.
From the sideline, let's catch up with Doris Boone.
Well, gentlemen, last year was a great bounce-back season for Andre Blotch with the Brooklyn Nets. He took the number 0 for his jersey, saying he liked the motto, from zero to hero. He wanted to go from being a guy who everyone had given up on, who'd been amnestied by the Wizards, to a valued player. Mission accomplished, Kevin.
He's really done a great job there, Doris. Thanks. Here is Livingston. Thornton, a screen on Lowry. And Teletovich kicks to Thornton. And there's the pass to Teletovich. No good from outside. Got the defender off his feet with the pump fake, but couldn't knock it down. Vasquez dishes to Salmons. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Well, they've settled into a pretty nice groove here offensively in the second quarter.
Yeah, I like the way they picked up the pace shooting the ball. I mean, the field goal percentage, upwards of 50% now.
And Toronto making a change here. DeRozan's checked in. The Raptors have shot 67% from the line tonight, going 4-6.
Well, this is a good free throw shooting team a year ago. They hit about 79% of their free throws as a unit.
You know, success at the line just became contagious for them. A few guys got on a roll, and it carried over to the rest of the team.
Pass to Pierce.
Come on, box it out, man.
He dishes it to Livingston. He passes to Thornton. The Nets need to get a shot off here. Teletovich misses.
Hard work on the glass once again, fellas. They put a lot of effort into their rebound.
Well, you get more rebounds, you get more possessions, more shots at the hoop, and oftentimes that decides the game.
Out to DeRozan. Fires for 3. That's good. DeRozan's got 7 points in the game.
And they've set up countless buckets off assists. That's a huge part of what they've been doing here today. A
lot of dime dropping going on out there, Steve.
Well, head coach Jason Kidd, that's a phrase I didn't expect to hear this quickly, but Kidd wasted no time. Only a matter of weeks after he announced his retirement, as a player, he was named the head coach of the Brooklyn Nets. And it's going to be interesting to see the transition. Kid, obviously, great basketball IQ, so well respected as a person in the league. I think it's just a matter of time before he really finds his footing and becomes an excellent coach.
It's Salmons on the wing, defended by Toledovich. DeRozan, that falls. Great assist by Vasquez. DeRozan's got six here in this quarter.
Well, it looks like he's finally found his footing in this game. His first quarter was a real struggle, but he's got it going now.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn. And back to Coach Jason Kidd-Clark, a rookie at the coaching profession, but one of the most intelligent, respected point guards over his 19 years in the NBA.
Yeah, always respected as a leader, and his basketball IQ off the charts. So I think he's one of the few guys that could go right from playing to being a successful head coach.
Livingston kicks to Pierce. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
You know, he still's got something left in the tank and in the league. But last year, the Celtics already announced that they plan on retiring Paul Pierce's number when he does decide to hang it up. A well-deserved honor for one of the all-time great Celtics.
Pierce hits two. And guys, Pierce has said it. It was his wish to retire a Celtic.
Yeah, I think it's a tough call sometimes. You know, the team likely is past its championship window. A rebuild is a logical thing. But for your veteran star, I mean, how does he fit in with that? Sometimes, you know, emotion gets caught up in your decision-making process, but you got to do what's best for the team.
It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Left side, Williams. Backing him down is Johnson. Let's it go from 11. And again, no good by Brooklyn.
Well, an 8-rebound advantage like the one they have now is always going to swing the score hard in that team's direction.
And that's certainly been the case today. Their rebounding has made a huge difference. You know, even though he missed that three-point shot, I think the defense has to do a better job of challenging the shot.
Yeah, because you know if you continue to give up open looks like that, you're in big trouble.
Here is Livingston. Johnson outside. Six to shoot. DeRozan defending. Fade away. Second chance shot. And Garnett misses. Toronto leading by 10. And DeRozan kicks to Valanciunas. Passes it to Johnson. Rebound, Brooklyn. Garnett's got four rebounds now tonight.
You know, it's been a while since the Nets have been one of the feared teams in the East. They had their best season since their days when they would make trips to the finals in the early 2000s. Really an excellent turnaround effort from the entire organization.
He's got a nice touch on that shot normally, but good defense there clogging the lane.
DeRozan passes to Ross. And the Raptors miss again. Brooklyn's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Johnson outside. That cuts the lead to single digits. And for the Nets, who were one of the big turnaround stories from last season, they did it by beating a team, Steve, they were supposed to in the rest of the Eastern Conference. Great record against the East.
Yeah, 36-16 against their Eastern foes. So pretty solid in that regard. You know, they decided early on that the key was they had to get home court advantage in the first round. And they set their goal and they hit it. Unfortunately, they got knocked off by Chicago in that first round.
Patrick Patterson, he's checked in for the Raptors. Here is Livingston, defended by Ross. Right side, Williams. There's the feed to Livingston. Shoots a three. The rebound by Patterson. Patterson's got his fourth rebound in this one.
They're really getting the work done inside with their rebound.
Yeah, not giving up too many second chance opportunities, which is always important, and it's been one of the reasons they have the lead right now.
Livingston dishes to Pierce. Little turnaround, and it comes off the front of the rim.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Johnson kicks to Ross. Back to Johnson.
Oh, my goodness.
What a huge play.
Tell you what, he's going to put that one in his scrapbook. Absolutely insane with that dunk.
Well, now they're starting to rub it in, aren't they? Have build up a lead, and here we go, folks. It's showtime.
And why not? I mean, the more plays they make like that, the more they'll have these guys on the ropes.
Feeds it to Johnson. He kicks to Williams. A finger roll finish at the bucket. Williams has got 6 points.
Great move to the hoop, and I love the finger roll finish.
And so it looks like the Raptors will retain possession here. The Raptors making a switch here. Novak's checked in. And here's Lowry. 6 points for him. The dish to Ross. Back to Lowry. Shot clock at 5. And again, no good by Toronto.
Well, he's been trying to add that mid-range shot to his arsenal, but it still isn't there.
Johnson inside. Patterson defending. Offensive rebound. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Strong off the offensive rebound.
What a play. They can cut this lead down if they start converting more of their second points.
I'm with you there.
Yeah, but you wonder, where were those earlier? They're just hustling more now.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Hey, guys, you know, the Raptors were at the bottom of the Atlantic Division once again this past season, but the silver lining there is that they seem to be improved as a team. The problem is the rest of the division improved right along with them.
Allen Anderson's checked in for Sean Livingston. He's perfect from the line this time. Well, the Raptors, the bottom of the Atlantic with a record of 5-11 against the rest of that division. They'll need to do better than that to climb out of the cellar this season.
Well, it's going to take a lot. Raptors won 34 games last year, but they still found themselves struggling to win games in the Atlantic. It is a good division. But they can make improvement. There's plenty of talent there, and I think that's going to be one of the keys this year, how well they play against teams in the Atlantic.
And the technical free throw is good. Kirilenko, the pass to Williams. With the lead pass, and that one's good. Plumlee's got his second basket of the game.
I think they need to get much more disruptive defensively. They can't just keep allowing these easy baskets.
I agree. They need more energy in the post, maybe some double teaming. They've got to get their defense in gear.
And the foul called on Joe Johnson. That's foul number 2 for him.
And another foul would give him 3 before the half, something to keep our eyes on.
Now DeRozan. He's got 10. Back to Patterson. Dishes to Ross. No good from outside. Nets trailed by 5. And a chance here to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Doris Burke. Hi, Doris.
Yes, Kevin. For Jason Kidd, a Hall of Fame caliber point guard in his 19 years as a player, about a week after retiring, it was announced he returned to the league as head coach of the Brooklyn Nets. He said, quote, "I went from being one of the oldest guys in the league to being a rookie all over again." Kevin, he said it makes him feel young again.
Nice to have him back. Thanks, Doris. Kicks to Patterson. Stolen by Anderson. It's Williams with the drive. Lowry with the ball. He's got 6. Novak kicks to DeRozan. Raptors moving the ball around. Here's Ross. And the Raptors miss again.
You know, guys, Kirilenko took a year off from the NBA in 11-12 to play in his native Russia, and he won the EuroLeague MVP. Also helped Russia bring home the bronze in London, and last season was a key player for Minnesota.
And for Kirilenko last season, as you mentioned, Clark, a big role for the Timberwolves. Now, Steve, if he can just stay healthy.
Yeah, all those injuries. He missed 18 games last year, but with his defense and his versatility, he helped keep that team afloat.
And both free throws good for Anderson.
A big change for the Nets, who stormed up the leaderboard in the East and even had a chance at taking a very tough Atlantic division last season. They actually were in the picture for the title until the end.
Novak dishes to DeRozan. He feeds it to Lowry. Pulls up. Nice shot from the wing. Lowry's got 8 points. Brooklyn with the ball. They trail by 3. And the Nets' first goal going forward this year is to make that jump into the best team in New York and the rest of the division. Steve, a lot of strong teams in the Atlantic, but they do well against them.
Yeah, last year they had the best interdivision record than anybody in the Atlantic. So, you know, if you can take care of business within your division, it always puts you in a good position down the stretch.
For Toronto, they've gone 6 of 13 so far from the field here in the second quarter. Back to Patterson. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Lowry's got 3 assists in the game. Outside Williams. Kirilenko the pass to Johnson. Outside Williams. Here's the 3. And this sure that one drops. Williams has got 5 points in the quarter.
Well, Kevin, probably his greatest value lies in his tremendous three-point shooting. And he's out on the perimeter, and it gives them the ability to really stretch the defense out.
And one of his other great qualities, Steve.
Oh, how about that basketball,
that
man?
Beautiful.
Wow.
I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points. Not the dramatics.
Oh, come on, Clark. He had to go for it, didn't he?
I'm with you, Kevin. You can't fault him for that. I mean, just let him go. Who cares?
Well, no team likes to have their first-round pick belong to another team. It gets worse when you're a lottery team yourself and you're trying to build your talent base up. But the Raptors' number 12 pick in this summer's draft went to one of the elite teams in Oklahoma City.
A 3 from Anderson. It's rebounded by Novak. Raptors leading by 3. And DeRozan kicks the loan. Gets the bucket. Lowry's got 10 points.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening, Steve.
No, it's off the charts. It really is. And defensively, I mean, they have to start shutting down some of those lanes to the hoop.
And that one's good. And it's 8 points for Joe Johnson. Well, Clark, as you said, the Thunder got the Raptors' first selection this last year. Only the way the Raptors would have been able to hang on to it was, Steve, if they jumped up to the top 3 in the lottery.
And as bad as it might seem for the Raptors to have not had a first, I mean, and it is bad, it was as good as any other time for them to not have a first-round pick because the draft wasn't deep, and the Raptors have a lot of young talent already and that they can make improvements with.
He had to clear some space for himself to get that rebound. Not easy in there among the big bodies.
Ross can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper.
He's going to play his way right onto the bench and out of the game if he continues to shoot it like he has so far in this quarter.
Johnson dishes to Williams. Anderson right side. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. Anderson's got 8 points. Lowry with the ball. Here's Ross. No good on the buzzer beater. And the first half ends in a close one. It's the Raptors. They're up.
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Tipping off your halftime show, I'm Damon Bruce. And a close
the Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And as we return, a view here of the landmark Statue of Liberty, illuminating this beautiful night.
You know, Lowry is playing well. He's got 13 points, and the three-pointers have been dropping for him. He's got 3 of them.
Well, as long as he's continuing to make them, I think they should make him more of a focal point of this offense.
Come on, baby. Hit one more.
Lowry against Williams. Pass to Johnson. They find Jay on the way, and hit on the basket. Book it. Johnson's got the first points to start out the third quarter for the Nets. The drive by Lowry. There's the pass to Valanciunas. Ross. He dishes it to Lowry. Johnson against Pierce. Johnson, the pass to Valanciunas. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2. This is his first free throw of the game. The free throw drops for Valanciunas.
An up and down season for the Nets last year, and the playoffs were just more of the same. They ended up getting knocked out by the Bulls in the only first round matchup that went to seven games.
Well, back to the Nets in the playoffs. They lost a game at Barclays early and looked to be on the ropes down 3-1 after four games, but they did well just to steal one in Chicago and force a game seven.
What a strange series that was. The Bulls made that miracle comeback behind Nate Robinson in one game and then ended up going on the road to Brooklyn and winning game seven. What a disappointment for the Nets in their debut season in Brooklyn.
Lowry with the ball. Williams picks him up. Lowry kicks to Ross. Back to Lowry. Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. And it's Lowry penetrating. No good from Ross.
Some of the shots he's taken have been real head scratches. I mean, come on. He's out there playing like it's a game of horse at the park. It's been a good one for Williams. He has 9 points and four assists as well.
He has been fundamentally sound today, making great passes and knocking down his free throws.
And guys, those are two things they've really needed from him.
The first free throw is good. And both free throws good for Williams. First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter. Lowry kicks to Valanciunas. DeMar DeRozan on the wing. DeRozan gets a screen from Valanciunas. Ross dishes to Lowry. Connects from three-point range. Lowry's got 16.
But you can't leave him alone, especially from long range.
2 minutes into the second half of play now. Here is Livingston. Pass to Williams. The feed to Livingston. Clock at six. Williams shoots from the high post. Another miss by Williams. Raptors leading by four. Passes to DeRozan. Raptors moving the ball around. No good from Valanciunas.
And they've been off target now on three of the first four shots they've taken in this second half.
Here is Livingston. He's guarded by Johnson. And Pierce, here we go. The open shot by Johnson. Plenty of room to knock down the shot. Johnson's got four this quarter.
You know, even though he's older and won't be putting up points in the mid-20s like he once did with regularity, when you talk about clutch shots and somebody you want to take clutch shots, Paul Pierce is still one of your guys. Well, that's a lot of bricks by them early in the second. Only one make on five tries so far in the second half.
Raptors have been getting it done at the line, 10 for 12. Going back to Pierce's offensive game, one of the most versatile one-on-one scorers in the game to this day, Steve.
Yeah, he can score inside, out, in between, and a very smart passer as well. Plays the game with a great pace. He's just got so much strength and rhythm to his game that he sort of does whatever he wants out there.
And gets his teammates involved as well.
Mm-hmm.
Right around 3 minutes into the second half. Now here's Williams. 11 points in the game. He passes to Livingston. Feeds it to Pierce. Four on the clock. Smooth as silk on the finger roll. Pierce has got 6 points.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Second half here. We're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Johnson with a screen on Williams. Lowry. DeRozan. He kicks it to Valanciunas. Stolen by Pierce. Here is Livingston. Defended by Ross. Livingston passes to Williams. Garnett with the screen for Williams. Garnett outside. Shot clock at six. The dish to Johnson. Williams while recovering. And it's Williams. That time the assist by Johnson. Johnson's got three assists in the game. Lowry kicks to Ross. Ross gets a screen from Valanciunas. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Valanciunas has got 10 points in the game.
The second he got around the pick and shook his man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy dude. Very, very well done.
Johnson outside. Dishes it to Williams. Kicks it to Garnett. Back to Williams. He feeds it to Garnett. On the wing, Williams. And again, Brooklyn with the triple.
You know, we really haven't seen the same focus defensively that we did in the first half.
Lowry against Williams. Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. Lowry kicks to Valanciunas. Excellent D there from Williams. Nets leading by three. Shot from 16. And it's Brooklyn scoring again.
I'll tell you what, the first half may have been a little slow, but both clubs really picking up the intensity here in the second.
I'll say that's for sure. I mean, things have really ramped up here.
And Valanciunas kicks to Ross. No good on the three.
Oh, boy, he is just cold as ice. I don't think he's going to be the one to help them cut into the lead.
Williams attacking. Back to Johnson. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
You know, one part of Joe Johnson's game that tends to get overlooked, guys, is his ability to create space with the dribble. He's got great size, and that ability makes him the potent scorer he is.
And for Joe Johnson, as you mentioned, Clark, great size, and he's comfortable, truly, Steve, from shooting anywhere on the floor.
Yeah, and whether it's a spot up or off the dribble, he can go either direction. He's so strong, excellent ball handling ability. But I think he could do a little more damage inside if he chose to. He's got the body to be a good post-up player.
And it's Lowry penetrating. Pass to Solomons. The pass to Johnson. Back to Solomons. Here's DeRozan. Bangs home the trifecta. DeRozan's got 13.
His shooting has been so good today. He may have to take it upon himself to try to get his club out of this hole.
Here is Livingston. Back to Blotch. He dishes it to Livingston. The Nets working the ball around now. Pass to Blotch. DeRozan with the rebound. Raptors trail by four. The feed now to Lowry. Passes it to DeRozan. Another miss by DeRozan. Brooklyn's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. Livingston kicks to Thornton. Blocked. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way. And some changes here for the Raptors. Jonas Valanciunas comes in for Amir Johnson. And Terrence Ross is subbed in for DeMar DeRozan. Outside Lowry. Ross. And again, no good by Toronto.
Not a bad look for him on that shot, but it just doesn't seem to be his night tonight. Well, for the Brooklyn Nets, the ninth best record in the league last season. Good size inside and on the wings. They felt like they needed to ramp it up a bit to compete with Miami and LeBron James.
Lowry against Williams. Lowry kicks to Selmans. That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. Selmans got 6 points.
Nice kick out after the defense had collapsed on it.
And Clark, you were talking about the Nets' size, the second best rebounding team in the NBA, Steve, last season.
Yeah, they really controlled the glass. Good rotation in their front court with the size and the tenacity. Now, of course, they've got additional help with Garnett and Kirilenko. So this is a team that can really hit the boards and dominate the paint.
And Thornton kicks to Pierce. Another shot. He lays it in. 8 points for him. Raptors trail by five. Lowry drives in, feeds it to Selmans. He passes to Ross. And the Raptors hit again from deep.
They're going back to the three-point shot over and over and over.
That was the ninth straight point from behind the arc, Clark. It feels like they're finding the holes in this defense.
You can see the eye contact there. Gave a little nod and then burst to the rim for the alley-oop slam.
No doubt, Clark. A pair of teammates with a terrific feel for each other out on the floor. Mm-hmm.
And what a play to make in a close game. A potential momentum builder.
Patterson dishes to Valanciunas. Working on Zaletovic. Got a piece of it. He kicks it to Ross. He feeds it to Salmons. A three-pointer off the mark. Nets leading by four. Pierce gets the screen from Blatch. He shoots again. Nice D from Patterson. The Raptors shooting is leaving some to be desired. Just 36% here in the third quarter. Ross kicks to Patterson. Outside Lowry. Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. Salmons passes to Ross. Four on the shot clock. Sinks the triple. Ross has got nine.
That's now a dozen straight points coming off wide open three-pointers.
You know what it looks like to me out there, guys? I mean, it looks like All-Star Weekend out there. We know how much defense is played. There is actually defense during the All-Star Weekend. No D.
Lowry with the ball. He's got 16. Here's Patterson, and he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up. There it is, guys, that Ole defense. Just watching him go, Clark, right by.
I think we might be seeing which team is ready to take control of this game.
Yeah, that's a dunk that could absolutely get them going. I agree, Clark.
Now, here's Thornton, defended by Ross. That's good. Blatch has got 4 points now in the quarter.
That's what they're hanging their hat on today, fellas. Hard-nosed, smash-mouth play down on the low block.
To me, that's the key to any game. Who can win the battle in the paint? And right now, they've got it going.
Vasquez, he's checked in for Kyle Lowry. Toronto trailing. And here's Vasquez. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. They set the pick. And Patterson kicks to Valanciunas. He flees off the pick and hammers it home.
And that's a nice finish for the big fella there. I mean, he used his length very well under the basket.
There may be more athletic players around the league, but, Steve, not many bigger ones.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, Kevin, I'd like to see him even take advantage of that size more often on the offensive end and be more aggressive.
Six on the shot clock. Backing him down is Johnson. Pierce, Patterson defending. Here's Bosch. But he stays with it. And the layup's good off the glass. Blatch has got 8 points. Guys, close one here. No team getting a huge advantage.
Yeah, that's exactly right. I mean, there have already been 5 lead changes, but nobody taking control of it.
Great matchup. I mean, these two teams really, really match up well talent-wise. I'm enjoying this.
Here's Valanciunas. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
And, you know, coming into the league out of Lithuania, Valanciunas, his reputation was more of a pick-and-roll big man, not the most skilled in the post, but he's starting to show some impressive moves with his back to the basket.
Rolling back to Valanciunas, a good foul shooter for a 7-footer, almost 80% in his rookie season.
That's why this team values him so highly. He's very skilled for a big man. He can spread the floor. And then when you add in his rebounding and what seems to be a good work ethic and passion for the game, I think Valanciunas has a chance to be special.
Salmons. Here's the dish to Patterson. Outside for Long. And stolen by Thornton. And now in transition is Thornton. Here we go. Here's Blatch. Can't get it to go. Great D that time from Vasquez. Kicks it to Patterson. Dishes to Salmons. Lowry. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Lowry's got 19 points.
Boy, they've come out of halftime just smoking hot from behind the arc.
Hey, trust me on this one, partner. They are going to continue to let them fly.
And we've watched 3 so far in this one. Raptors lead by 4. Dunk. Thanks for joining us again as we get set for the fourth quarter. A terrific game so far. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Raptors.
These long-range shots look like layups out there, guys.
You know, something else I've noticed is just how many of their baskets have been set up by assists throughout the game.
Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. Lowry dishes to Vasquez. Offline with his three. Nets trail by four. Thornton with it. Now guarded by Salmons. Salmons against Thornton. Joe Jackson on the way. No good with the triple.
Kevin, I didn't like that defensive effort at all, but they're lucky he missed it.
Yeah, they were very lucky defensively because there was some miscommunication there. They left him wide open. Plumlee's a big, physical, athletic center. He's a shot blocker, a space eater. Not much of an offensive player, but he can really run and jump.
Yeah, he's athletic and has good mobility. You're right, Steve. I think he passes the ball pretty well for a big guy. Didn't have to do that a lot in college. He can block shots. He does a little bit of everything. And it'll be interesting to see how he develops in the NBA. I think he's got good upside. There are some questions about his strength, but I think he'll add that as he goes forward.
Lowry gets a screen from Valanciunas. Pass to Vasquez. He dishes it to Patterson. Leads him in there. And Valanciunas kicks to Ross. Brooklyn with the rebound.
That's a shot he's got to hit. I mean, you don't get too many better looks from that range.
And Williams, here we go. Kirilenko, Patterson defending.
Really good job on the inside that time. I mean, he had to work for that rebound, and he got it done.
But three, the shot's good. Vasquez making the play. And the Raptors lead by six.
The D with very little pressure on their perimeter shooters. Three of the last five baskets they've allowed have been of the three-point variety.
Yeah, and unless they make some rotations and closeouts defensively, there's more to come, Clark.
Anderson kicks to Williams. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. Williams has got 13 points in the second half. Kicks it out to Vasquez. Let's the three fly. The Raptors rebound. The pass to Ross. The tray and the basket good.
I love it when a player like this shakes off a poor first half and comes back strong like he has, showing a lot of confidence in his game.
Williams against Lowry. Right side, Williams. Pass to Anderson. Now the feed to Kirilenko. Nets passing it around. Here's Plumlee. Toronto grabs the miss. Ross has got six rebounds now in the game. Patterson passes to Ross. That's good. And it's an eight-point Toronto lead.
This is a fantastic performance in this half. He didn't play as well in the first, but you just know with this guy, he's always ready to turn it around.
Johnson, defended by Ross. Shoots a fader, and the shot is good from Johnson.
Well, he could have earned some style points there, but he really doesn't need to use the fadeaway when he's that wide open.
Vasquez kicks to Lowry. Puts up the baby hook. Passes it to Ross. Outside Lowry. Vasquez. Patterson gets a screen from Valanciunas. Patterson dishes to Vasquez. Just five on the clock. And Lowry gets it to go.
Wow. Wow, what a great performance from him. He's hit three in each half.
Anderson passes to Kirilenko. Back to Anderson. Feeds to Johnson. He kicks to Anderson. Puts it up. That's in, coming off an assist from Johnson. Johnson's got four assists in the game.
Boy, they have been terrific from beyond the arc here in the second half. You look at the percentages. Good number.
Just what the pharmacist prescribed. Those three-point bombs will erase the deficit quickly if they keep it up.
Ross kicks to Valanciunas. Good. Valanciunas has got 10 points here in the second half.
And he's made the most of his chances, hasn't he? He really needs to continue to work for those good looks.
Williams dishes to Anderson. Johnson. He passes it to Plumlee. Rebounded by Valanciunas. Valanciunas has got rebound number five here tonight. Deflects the pass. And that'll be Toronto as it goes out of bounds. Raptors retain possession. The Raptors making a switch here. And Toronto has possession. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Ross, he's guarded by Johnson. Ross passes to Selmans. He feeds it to Ross. Just 5 to shoot. The Raptors need to get a shot off. Lowry, he squares up and sinks it. Lowry's got 5 points in the quarter.
And at the offensive end, he's done about as much as they could have hoped for today.
Now the dish to Thornton. Kicks to Johnson. Salmon's covering the 9-foot shot. That one off the back iron and out.
It just hasn't been a very good day for him, guys. They need him to start burying some of those.
That falls. Nice feed that time from Kyle Lowry. And the Raptors lead by 13.
They've had the hotter hand in the first half so far, no question.
Yeah, it's because of all the high percentage shots they've been working for and getting.
And there's the call on Kyle Lowry. And that'll be his third foul so far. Amir Johnson's checked in for Patrick Patterson. And the foul on Jonas Valanciunas. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Well, yeah, he had not established position.
You know, I prefer the refs to whistle with a block when in doubt. I thought that was a good call there.
Al Thornton dishes it to Williams. Shot clock at 6. And Paula kicks to Williams. Takes a 3. They get it back. Johnson with the block.
They've shown effort and aggression in the paint right from the tip. Their rebounding edge is impressive.
And I'll tell you what, they've turned a lot of those rebounds into points at the other end.
Here's Valanciunas, and there are the Raptors with another bucket.
They're playing with a purpose, guys. The big lead becoming bigger. I like the look in their eyes.
And it's on both ends that they've been controlling the action.
Johnson dishes to Plumlee. Back to Johnson. Makes the lead pass. And it's Plumlee that time on the assist by Johnson. 9 points for Mason Plumlee.
Can't pass up that kind of look.
Raptors leading by 13. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him.
It was a slow start at first for Valanciunas, partially because he was hampered by injuries at times. But towards the midpoint of the season, I think he really started to find himself.
DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for the Raptors. And for Valanciunas, in his rookie season, you got to figure, Clark, a big part of it, adjusting to the size and the strength of the NBA.
You're all over it, Kevin. He does need to add some muscle. He's athletic, gets up and down the floor pretty well, has excellent hands, which you can't teach. So that's an asset you love to see. I think in time, he could be one of the top scoring centers in the league.
And the jam by Ross.
Boy, I love it. Active hands on the steal, active feet on the fast break.
And Clark Power on the dunk.
And guys, this is just too close of a game to be giving the ball up like that and then failing to get back in transition.
Nets trail by 16. Pass to Livingston. Johnson outside. DeRozan defending. 5 on the clock. Johnson's shot is off. Raptors leading by 16. DeMar DeRozan on the wing. And out of bounds as Brooklyn gains possession.
Now, severe lack of awareness on his part. He had no idea who he was near the out of bounds line.
Brooklyn's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. Here is Livingston. Back to Williams. He dishes it to Plumlee. And the pass to Williams. The good-looking shot from the wing. Williams has got 24. Toronto's gone 3-5 from beyond the arc since the final quarter's gotten underway. Valanciunas defended by Plumlee. And DeRozan kicks to Ross. And again, Toronto with the triple.
That's been their bread and butter in the second half. They've really knocked down their long-range shots.
Well, and as hot as they've been, there's no need to change their offense. Just continue to play the way you're playing. You're going to get open looks.
Livingston kicks to Johnson. DeRozan defending. Johnson can't get it to go.
I think he's got to regroup and get himself together here. I mean, something's going wrong with him this quarter. He's really falling off.
And Valanciunas with the block. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Ross. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for him.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots just have not dropped for him today.
And it's out of bounds. The Raptors will take it the other way. And the Nets making a change here. Garnett's checked in. Lowry kicks to DeRozan. Johnson sets the screen for DeRozan. Johnson, Pierce covering. Johnson off the pick from Lowry. Used that pick to get in close. 9 points for Johnson.
A very hot shooting second half has seen them bring that field goal percentage way up.
Yeah, they're cruising now, really looking to add to this lead. And this has been a clinic, Clark.
Williams passes to Pierce. The feed to Garnett. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Gets on Jonas Valanciunas.
And Kevin Garnett, remember last year in Boston, played a lot of center, but now with the Nets, will most likely go back to his natural power forward spot playing alongside Brook Lopez.
You mentioned Kevin Garnett at center. He's listed at 6'11", but I don't know, Clark. He looks taller than that, but he's really stuck on that 6'11 size.
Yeah, a lot of guys want to stay south of 7 feet. I don't know why. It's something psychological or personal. Guys just feel better about being listed under the 7 feet tall, but the key with him is he's always played like a 7-footer, a very skilled and productive 7-footer at that.
Johnson with a screen on Williams. Passes it to Valanciunas. It's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
Well, the Nets have to do a better job guarding against Valanciunas.
19 points and a couple of great-looking rejections. So far, two blocks.
Now, he's anticipated the ball movement down low. He's finding angles, and that's why he's able to go up there and really control that glass area with his shot block.
Johnson can't hit.
I'll tell you what, the way he's been going this quarter, guys, they're going to need somebody else to pick up the slack.
Valanciunas dishes to Johnson. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face. And the Raptors lead by 19. Williams kicks to Pierce. Johnson outside. DeRozan defending.
2 minutes.
Back to Johnson. There's the triple. Another miss by Johnson.
I think it's going to be tough for them to trim this deficit if he keeps missing those kinds of shots, Kevin. I mean, they need his points.
Yeah, he had not established position.
You know, I prefer the refs to whistle with a block when in doubt. I thought that was a good call there.
First free throw is good.
You know, when Terrence Ross was drafted 8th overall, a lot of people were kind of scratching their heads as to why the Raptors would take him at that position. Some debate and uncertainty still resides there in the minds of some. But it's not quite as questioned because he's shown that he's got the tools to be a great wing player down the road.
Brooklyn with the rebound. Garnett's got 6 rebounds here tonight. And Williams, here we go. It's stolen by DeRozan. Fast break, Toronto. Pass to Ross. Back to DeRozan. Outside for Lowry. Toronto working the ball around now. Ross, that's good. Ross has got 13 points now in the quarter. Well, even though Terrence Ross didn't get the most playing time in his rookie season, he got enough on a consistent basis to flash what he was capable of with the Toronto Raptors last year.
Well, really, as a rookie, all you want is a chance to show what you can do on the court. And I thought Ross did that. Made some highlight reel plays with his athleticism. Can really run and get up and dunk. And he's got a nice three-point stroke as well.
Boy, it's been a tough go in terms of fouls for him. I mean, my goodness, he can't stay out of the way of fouls.
And he can't get the first one. The Raptors making a switch here. That one misses.
Guys, the league is always thirsty for shooting. Look no further than Steve Novak, a pure shooter, a specialist. Not exactly very athletic. At 6'10", he's never even dunked in a game, but he can stroke.
Vasquez passes to Selmans. Out to DeRozan. 6 to shoot. Off target from outside. Brooklyn's gotten just 1 of 4 3-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. 5-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Dladovich's shot is good. Now Vasquez. Well, for the Raptors, they can just run out the clock. Novak dishes to Vasquez. Hayes working on Blatch. Hayes down low, defended by Blatch. The shot's good from Hayes.
And the crowd here, of course, not happy about the outcome. But you know what? We saw a team tonight that came in prepared to do battle on the road. And they clearly wanted to win.
You know, they were determined to steal this game. And they showed it, Steve. Played harder and got the job done.
And so Toronto takes this one, but by a big margin. They put on a show tonight, thoroughly.